Hey everyone, and welcome to your carrier update presented by PowerFleet. I'm Zach Strickland. So, Mike?
Yes, sir.
Guess what's happened to the tender rejection index?
Came down.
It came down slightly. You got a 50-50
shot. It's going
shot.
Like this, right?
Yeah, it's bouncing around right between that 24 and 25% range. You know, we had a little blip there for a minute and it didn't really do much. Didn't have a lot of traction. We're waiting on it to do something significant at this point, but it's really just staying stable. So carriers out there, don't expect any rapid changes on the spot market in aggregate right now. Looking at year over year here, we've got the last 2 years.
A little different, eh?
Yeah, we've had a dramatic change year over year. You know, tender rejection rates for the last 2 years. In 2019, you know, we were starting to come back up out of that, or 2020, I should say, we were coming back up out of that trough. 2019, we were still kind of, we were contracting really off of that 2018, you know, huge market that we had.
Yeah.
And 2019, of course, as we all know, was a little bit, you know, didn't have a lot of luster to it, not a lot of volatility down there. But last year, we were coming out of that 2.5% tender rejection rate. Now we're at 24%.
24%,
yeah.
Right? And we're just hovering here, right?
We're hovering. We're waiting. It's almost, you see the trend line there? It's coming back down.
It is.
We're slowly starting to pull off of that peak that we saw around, ironically, late February.
Part of this was the Texas freeze, though, too, right?
Yeah,
that had a big deal with that as well, yeah.
Yeah, the Texas freeze shot tender rejection rates back up from 20%. We still haven't come all the way back down to that. So.
No.
We're in a holding pattern for now, but it is starting to trend back down slowly. People are kind of getting in position so far. So going to our next chart, looking at van and reefer rejection rates. You know, just to break it down a little bit further here, reefer rejections up around 41%. They are trending lower, but have ticked up the last day or so. You know, the overall trend though is still to come down like the rest of the rejection rate that we saw. Van, not a lot of movement. This is crazy to me. It's 24.69% right
just
now.
Just one in four being rejected.
That's just the way it is
from now on, right?
Yeah, I mean,
we used to look at like the Inland Empire and say, "Wow, 5% rejection. The Earth is it's over,"
yeah.
Right? Now
right.
17's like great.
Yeah. Now it would be amazing if we were at 20%. If anything. Yeah, one out of every four loads still getting rejected there. Reefer, not a big change, you know, with produce season.
It is.
Not having a huge draw on the overall contracted reefer market right now. So going into the weighted rejection index map on our next chart here. Let's see, we have had some volatility over the last week in some individual granularities. You see Ontario, we talked about it yesterday. Los Angeles is still... you know, seeing a sequential decline week over week in tender rejection rates. They've actually fallen all the way down to 15%.
That's amazing.
Which you saw the national average at 24% right now. It is not, you know, it is well below average. Carriers are rushing out there to cover that long haul freight as much as
so it is. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
I mean, because their volumes are very, very high.
Yes.
Right? And that's why you see that in the height, right? That's
exactly.
Their volumes. And that's why this a slight movement there turns it red, because it affects all these smaller markets, right?
Exactly. They have a huge market share, and that's what that weight, that's what that height is on each one of these markets. You see Atlanta here showing up in blue this week. That means that tender rejection rates are on the rise once again out of the Atlanta market. You know, and then we have the Southeastern corridor down here where we had Savannah really showing a lot of action over the last few weeks. And it's starting to, I wouldn't say like cool off dramatically, but it's starting to come down off that all-time high.
So that's interesting to me over here, Zach, if you don't mind me asking a question here, is you see the blue in Atlanta with the weighted tender rejections is up,
Yes. Obviously,
right? Mm-hmm. But Savannah, it's down.
Yep.
Yet the volume in Atlanta is up.
Right.
So why aren't carriers going to Atlanta to pull this stuff? Is it because they're gritting the long haul out of Savannah, getting out of there? Is there more coming to the middle now because of diversion?
Yeah. Well, I mean, think about it. Think about how tight the market is right now. They're running out to Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And they're leaving certain areas of the country exposed because they know that they're going to get tons of utilization coming out of Los Angeles, coming back this way. So getting those spot rates out of Los Angeles are worth a lot more than those spot rates out of Savannah.
Right.
Savannah averages about a 500 to 600 length of haul.
Right.
Los Angeles, 1,000 miles on average.
So, makes sense.
And then Atlanta, of course, just you see the height of the Atlanta market.
It's huge.
So any kind of decent change in rejection rate there is going to have a little bit more of an impact, especially over the Savannah market, which you can see has a lot of volume, but not near the volume that the Atlanta market has. Houston, we talked about it yesterday, still showing as one of the most significant tightenings over the last week or so. If we break it down a little bit further, let's look to our next chart here. Going into the Atlanta market, you can see Atlanta's been very volatile.
Oh, yeah.
35.37% on the reefer tender rejection rate. We talked about reefers bouncing up yesterday a little bit. So it is, out of the Southeast, we do see some reefer rejection rates increasing. So if you are a reefer carrier in this market, spot market activity should be on the rise this week versus last week. And then Van doing the same thing, sort of a bounce here.
Yeah, kind of a bounce there. I mean, it's definitely not an insulated market right now. Atlanta never is, right? It hits a lot of markets around it, and they affect it too, right? You got North Florida, Jacksonville sucking reefers, right?
Exactly. All that reefer activity, it's produce season in Florida. We had Mother's Day last week, so all those reefer carriers going down south. We've actually seen reefer rejection rates come down out of the Florida markets so far. And again, it's Atlanta's not a huge reefer outbound central or anything. A lot of DCs there for a lot of the food warehouses.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, Zach, for that update.